In this video, we are going to discuss about access specifiers in C++ or visibility labels in C++. Mainly in C++, we have three access specifiers are there. They are, first one is public, second one is private, third one is protected. Whereas Java supports default also. In C++, we don't have default access specifier. So C++ supports these three access specifiers. In this video, let us discuss these three access specifiers one by one. The first one is public access specifiers. Public access specifier. So what is public access specifier? So under the public section, access specifier means after the access specifier, we can use this colon symbol. The members of the public can be accessible throughout the program. So inside that class, we can access the members. Outside the class, in main function, anywhere in the program, we can access the members of the public. So what are the members? Here the members may be either variables or functions. So we can access the public variables, the public members from anywhere in the program. Let's see what is private access specifier. So here also, private access specifier means we have to use private and it ends with colon symbol. The members of the private can be accessible from only inside the class only. So from outside the class, we can't access private members. From the main function also, we can't access private members. So private members are always accessible from only inside the class only. Let us see what is protected access specifier. Protected access specifier means those members can be accessible inside the class as well as from its derived class also. Derived class means we have a concept called inheritance. Inheritance means the process of creating a new class from old class. Here the new class is called as derived class. Old class is called as base class. So we can access the members of the protected inside that class as well as from its derived class also. So let us discuss these three access specifiers with the help of an example program. First let's see about public access specifier. So first we have iostream.h. iostream.h, why? Because cout and cin objects are present in iostream.h. Next class, let name of the class is num. So initially we are demonstrating about public. So let us have public members. So public colon. So let we have two members, int a comma b. Next, under the public section only, let us define a function. So void display. So inside this display function, let us provide some values. Let a value is 1, b value is 2. So display a and b values. So cout less than a, less than b. Next, to close the class. Class declaration is over. Next, to from the main function, let us create an object. So num obj, call the display function. So obj.display. Okay. So now let us see this program. Here under the public section, we have AB member variables and display member function. We know that we can access public members anywhere in the program. So from outside the class. So we can define several other classes. In those classes also, we can access these members. So public means anywhere in the program, we can access those members. So num obj, obj.display. So control goes to the display function. So a value 1, b value 2. So cout less than a, less than b. So what is a value 1, b value 2. So that will be printed. If you want, we can access those members also directly. So what is the object name? Obj. So obj.a is equal to 10. So likewise, obj.b is equal to 20. Let us remove these statements. Next to obj.display. obj.display. Okay, now. So now obj, an object is created. obj.a is equal to 10. So inside this a, 10 will be stored. obj.b is equal to 20. So inside the B20 will be stored, go B is dot display. So control goes to the display function, less than A, less than B. So 1020 will be printed. Here, why? Because these two are public members. Public members means we can access them from the main function also, from anywhere in the program, we can access those members. Now let us see about private. Private. Okay, let us see how this will get executed. So obj.a is equal to 10, obj.b is equal to 20. The compiler will display error message. Why? Because A and B are declared under the private section. We can access private members from only inside this class only. So we can't access AB from the main function. Why? Because they are private members. So in order to access the private members, if we write like this, then the compiler will display error message. Okay. Here display function is also defined under the private section. We can't access this display function from the main function. Why? Because display means private member function. So private members are accessible from only inside the class only. So that's why it is better to define display function under the public section. So here we have display function. So under this, let us perform some initializations. A is equal to 1, B is equal to 20. Now let us call like this, obj.display. Okay. So num obj, obj.display. Display function is defined under the public section. We can access the public member function from anywhere in the program. So obj.display means control goes to the display function. So A value 1, B value 2. Here we can access private members using the public member function of the same class. We can access the private members, private member variables by using the public member function of the same class. So here display is public member function of the same class. So we can access these two private member variables from this function. Okay. So we will get output as 1 and 2. Now let us see about protected. So in order to discuss the protected, we need to create derived class. Okay. Here we have a class like this. So let we have another class, class num2, class num2. So this is nothing but derived class. We know the syntax for derived class. Here we have to use an access specifier. Let the access specifier is public. And what is the base class name? Num is the base class name. Okay. Here let us assume that we have, here we are discussing about protected members. So protected. Okay. Protected. There is no need of any display function here. Protected. So under the, so in base class here we have two member variables AB. So those two are of protected type. Okay. Here we are creating a class called num2 class. This is nothing but base class. Base class. And this num2 is nothing but derived class. So we are creating the derived class using the base class num. Okay. So whenever we do like this, then what will happen is the protected members of the base class can be accessed in derived class also. Okay. So we can access AB in derived class also. So here we have, let us assume that here we have public section. Under the public section that we have a variable called C. So under the public section, let us define a function called display. Here let us perform some initializations. A value 1, B value 2, C value 3. Let us display ABC values. Less than A, less than B, less than C. Next to close the class. Next to main function. So from the main function, simply create an object. We always create object for the derived class. So num2 obj. Let us call the function display. So obj.display. So num2 obj. Why? Because num2 is derived class. Okay. Here we have created derived class from the base class num. So base class num contains two protected members. We know the advantage of the protected. We can use the protected members inside this class as well as from its derived class also. So now A and B will also become members of num2. So now num2 has three member variables, A, B and C. So now we have three member variables in num2, A, B, C. So under the display function, we have performed the initializations and we displayed A, B, C values. So from the main function, we have created an object, obj.display. So control goes to the display function and these three values will get printed. So this is about access specifiers. Access specifiers can also be called as visibility labels. Visibility labels in C++.